I've got a giant plant in my face. If you're a freelance photographer, or you're a cinematographer, or you're a graphic designer, or you're an artist, or you're a ceramicist, or you're someone who restores classic cars for a living, or you make murals, whatever happens, it's 2020, you should probably have some form of website. I've been meaning to make a website for ages, so when Wix got in contact asking if they could sponsor a video where I make a website, that seemed like a deal that was too good to be true. So today I'm going to be running you through the process of me building up a website for my production company. I'm going to be showing you all the ins and outs. We're going to go from start to finish. Hopefully by the end of this video I should have a pretty sweet looking site that people can visit and they can see all of my work presented nicely. If not, you'll never see this video.
So here we are on the Wix website, and all I'm going to do is click create new site, and that will take me through to this page right here, and then I can choose the sort of rough category that my website is going to be falling into. So I'm going to select photography because I would say that sounds about right, and instantly I have been presented with a bunch of options that all look really gorgeous, and I'm struggling to decide which one I want already. I do really like the large banner on this one. I think that's pretty cool. This is sweet. I mean, it does not fit my style of content that I create. It's so much less moody. This is so bright and vibrant, but I love it. I love this as well. Oh my goodness. I reckon this is it. I reckon this is the one. Okay, let's start editing this site together. And we can start getting things worked out. First things first, my name definitely is not Marcus Berg. So we should probably get rid of that. And I'm just going to delete that entirely. Because I think if I just add an image, I want to get the logo of my production company in place. So let's just click on this. Okay, and then I can upload some media onto here. That looks about right. In fact, I'll get all the different colors of my logo. I guess the reverse ones and also the black ones. I think I'm going to play around with the idea of a black background to this website because the films that we make are quite moody. You know, they're quite grungy in their colors, so it makes sense that we also have quite a grungy looking website. But there we go. Okay, so that one there. I'm going to try out the one that doesn't have any production company mention here, and I'm just going to chuck that up at the top for now. Then I'm going to come over to this area here and start messing around with the page background. All right. Okay, that's not looking too bad. Now, this gallery actually has its own background right now, so I assume we can do some messing around with that. There it is. Right, no color. Okay, so that means, alright, already this is kind of looking a little bit more cutting edge. Now, I want to make sure that that two-story logo actually follows the page down so it stays in the same place. Pin to screen. I mean, that sounds like it will do the thing that I want. Yes! Yes! Nice! Okay, so that logo is now following down the screen. This is going to look quite cool. When we start getting film thumbnails in here, this is already looking quite interesting.
Now, this feels like a good time to mention it. If you want your own professional website, then go to wix.com/go/mumbojumbo. The link is down in the description. It's also on the screen in big letters, probably covering my face right now.
Hello. Well, that seems interesting. So I can add videos into the mix? As much as this is cool, I don't want to be beholden to the thumbnails from my YouTube videos, because obviously the thumbnails from my YouTube videos, they have to be bright and eye-catching because you're competing with all the other thumbnails on YouTube, whereas I think on this website, because it's going to be quite a dark and moody website, these might be a tiny bit too bright, but that's a nice feature. I think I'm going to worry about all of that in a second. For now, I'm in the process of just trying to work out what I'm going to do with this section right here, which is like my menu navigation. I'm playing around with a few different fonts and a few different ideas here. Ooh, I'm a big fan of that. I need to find one that's really, really close to the one that I'm using here. Did I use Open Sans? Oh, that, yes, I think it is Open Sans. That looks identical. Fantastic. Now, if I give this a quick preview, you can see things are starting to look a tiny bit more coherent. This is starting to feel like a slightly more consistent website. Now, after loading in my actual images and seeing it like this, I'm a fan, but also I think it feels a little bit heavy now that we have the full-sized images, having also the black border. So I think I'm going to go back to a white design with the black logo and kind of go from there, because otherwise it feels like a very dense website. Whereas now that I've cleaned things up just a tiny bit, I would say that this is quite a good page for my portfolio. So this is kind of where all of the videos are actually going to be going, but I feel like this isn't the page that you should enter the website on, because although it's great, it's functional, it's nice and minimal, it doesn't say wow, you know, you don't see it and go whoa, and we want to be able to open the website and go whoa. I was about to ask if it's possible to hide your header and footer from a specific page, because obviously I don't want them on my splash page. Clearly that is the case. This little Wix helper is actually incredibly helpful. It's been saving me quite a bit. Yes, this is what I'm talking about. So we now have, I mean, this isn't my video, these are not my shots, but I like the concept. I like where this is going. I don't know where that button's going to take me. Yeah, no, apparently nowhere. But now, having added in some linkage action, hopefully, fingers crossed, look at this. Professional little web designer. But actually, I think this is a lot cleaner. I've added a menu into here, so now we can go to the different pages on the site. And also, I've added a slight texture to the video, which I think looks really, really nice. I can't wait to get my own video clips into that little splash screen right there. Anyway, on the topic of own video clips, it's probably about time that I actually add the videos connected up to these photos right here. So all I'm having to do is very simply just grab a web address. There we go. Go onto my YouTube channel, Growth of Home, copy link address, and that should do it. Then I want to make sure that the fonts that pop up as you hover over these things actually match up with the other ones on the website. So hopefully that should do everything. So now if we test this out, yes, that is more in keeping with the design of the site. This is looking good. This is looking good. Click through to here. We go back onto the home page. And then, of course, if I actually click on one of these images, then I get taken through to the video itself. Nice, 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 nice. Next up, we have the about page. Now, I didn't really show too much of this in the video because it's all stuff that you've kind of seen before. But all I've done here is I've added a strip that allows us to put some text up at the top here. I've got a little contact me button which opens up an email so people can inquire, and then down at the bottom I thought it'd be a good idea to just add a little gallery in so that people can see some behind the scenes action of some of the shoots. I think it goes without saying that a lot of the actual text, the kind of copy, I don't even know what it's called, the words that you put into a website, that is going to be worked on over the next couple of days. I just want to get the framework actually fully in place, because I will be the first to admit that this this isn't the best about section in the world. Okay, next up, services. So if I remember correctly, yeah, I can actually duplicate the page and then just call that services, and we can get rid of this dud, because this one right here, that is useless. Yes, we would have to build the page up from scratch. I don't really fancy doing that. So this services page, we can change up this section, put some slightly different photos in here, and that's perfect. Now, I was 100% on the home straight there, but then I'm such a perfectionist. I just wasn't quite sure on the full width website. So I did some tests with it being 980 pixels wide. I really, really like it. I love the airiness of it. I think it feels really, really nice. So now I'm going to put the other pages on a diet and we're going to slim them down a tiny bit. So if we go to the about page, currently this is full width. Okay, this is maximum width. And the way that we get around this and the way that we change this is we have to select things and we have to click on the stretch section, and then we have to make sure that stretch to full width isn't on, and then we change the width to be 980 pixels, and then we make sure that everything is all centered, and you can see that now it fits perfectly within the guidelines of the website. And I've kind of decided that I want this to almost be a consistent theme that runs throughout the website. So the idea of there being a big bold title, the line, and then a small little piece of text there. And you can see I've done that for the about page, and that's all lovely. And then also I have done it for the services page as well. I now have the final page all completed. So this is the series page, talking about the YouTube series that we do, where we're just running through videos a little bit like this, to be honest with you, behind the scenes stuff, industry secrets, all that sort of thing. I thought it'd be worth featuring on the website too, which means that now we actually have kind of a fully coherent website. Look at this. This looks real, because it is real. It's real, it looks professional. So, all there is left to do is work on creating some form of showreel type thing that I can put at the start of the website on that splash page, because we can't have just two random people with skateboards. That's not quite gonna do it. Here goes. This is the first time that I'm actually viewing the website fully with its loading screen, and I'm impressed. I can't believe it. We've gone from having zero website to actually having quite a cool looking website in without really too much stress. I mean, the only stress that happened was me being overly perfectionist and constantly changing my mind on how I wanted it to look. But in terms of actually managing to create something cool, this tool has worked out perfectly. I'm really, really proud of the end result. I would be happy to show this to clients, and I would be happy. I'm happy to put my name on this. I really am. So there we go. That is me building up my website. Once again, this video was sponsored by Wix. You can go to wix.com/go/mumbojumbo to create your own professional website if you want to. But anyway, I really do hope that you've enjoyed this video, and I will catch you in the next one. See ya!